This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is example 28 of solving equations with fractions. And now we're moving on to more than it just having fractions, there are also parentheses. So we have the distributive property to deal with as well. So as it turns out, we can either do the distributive property first and then work through the problem where you could multiply by the least common denominator to eliminate fractions, or you could multiply both sides of the equation by the least common denominator first and then do the distributive property. So we're going to do it both ways. So first let's do it by doing the distributive property in each side. So we have 3/4 times x plus 3/4 times 1, because you have to distribute it to both those numbers, equals 5/4 times x minus 5/4 times 1. So now we have done our distributive property, so now we're back to doing problems that have fractions in them. And the easiest way to do that is multiply both sides by the least common denominator. Now there's only one denominator, 4, and in fact all the fractions have that denominator, 4, so this one's going to be fairly simple to do. Our least common denominator is simply going to be 4. And when you multiply it by each term, it's going to cancel with every single denominator exactly one time. So the 4s are going to cancel. So if you want to see that, it's 4 times 3/4 x plus 4 times 3/4 plus equals 4 times 5/4 x minus 4 times 5/4. Many people don't need to do that step, and they just do it in your head. The 4s cancel all over the place here. So you would end up with 3x plus 3 equals 5x minus 5. So a lot of people can go directly to this step. They could do the canceling of the 4s in their head. So now we have an equation without any fractions, and there are also no parentheses, so we're down to a standard, kind of more basic equation. So we need to get the variables on one side, constants on the other, and solve it. It doesn't matter if you put the variables on the left or on the right, but I see I have a 3x on the left and a 5x on the right. I'm going to put the variables on the right, so the coefficient of x will be positive. So that means I want to subtract 3x from both sides. So I'll have a 2x on the right-hand side of the equation. And that means I don't want this minus 5, so I'm going to add 5 to both sides. So the constants end up being on the left-hand side. And I'm just going to divide by the coefficient of x. Don't divide by 8, you want to divide by the 2. So that 4 equals x, which we usually write that as x equals 4. Now you could have solved it by putting the variables on the left, and we'll do that as well. So let's start this problem over. Just keep in mind what I did is I distributed that 5/4. We're going to do it over where we're going to eliminate the fractions first. Okay, so I've got fraction on both sides, and 4 is the denominator, so the least common denominator is 4. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 4. Now, a lot of people get confused here, but watch. When you do 4 times 3/4 times x plus 1, remember this is just a times also. You don't distribute that 4 to the x plus 1. It cancels. You've already done this multiplication first. You don't distribute the 4, okay? That's a common mistake that people make. And the same thing over here, when I have 4 times 5/4, think of this as times x minus 1, these 4s cancel, so you don't distribute the 4 twice. If you did also multiply this inside parentheses by 4, you've just multiplied that right side by 16. All right, so what do we have then? We have 3, we're left with 3 times x plus 1 equals 5 times x minus 1. And now we could do the distributive property. So the difference here is We multiply by the least common denominator first to eliminate the fractions, and then we're going to do the distributive property to finish the problem. Okay, so this time I'll put the variables on the left. You can see the difference. I'm going to subtract 5x from both sides, which means I'm going to have a negative 2x. So by putting it on the left, notice the coefficient of x is negative. And if you're going to have the x's on the left-hand side, let's subtract 3 from both sides. Okay? So we have constants on the right. And this is negative 5 plus negative 3. So we've got a negative 8. See, I think I'll use green. And now we'd have to divide by negative 2 as opposed to positive 2. So our final answer is still x equals 4. So you've seen it done two different ways. You might try it on your own both ways and see if one seems easier than the other. Everybody's different. Both are completely valid. All right, let's check our answer. Let's make sure when we put in 4 for x, each side simplifies to the same number. And when you check, you're using order of operations. You don't do the distributive property. So we're going to put in 4 for x. And we have to simplify inside the parentheses first. That's order of operations. Simplify inside the parentheses. So you have 3 fourths times 5. And I'm going to write that as 5 over 1 so that you can see we get 15 fourths when we multiply the numerators and the denominators. Sorry, no box. Second one. We're going to put in 4 for x. And also, no distributive property, you just do the order of operations. So it's 3 over 1, giving 15 fourths. All right, so I got the same answer both times. So our answer, x equals 4, is correct. So the answer is x equals 4, or using the braces to show the solution set. We put the 4 inside the braces, and that's our answer. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.